So the love of the Father was sort of, I guess, the fruit of probably about 7 or 8 months worth of prayer. I felt really convicted to write a song, a new upbeat song, a song which could be, you know, played as sort of the first thing at church, which was going to help people to come through the door and sort of going to, I guess, really lift people's spirits and ready them for the rest of the service. And so I've been praying for months. I've been trying to write songs for months, and it just nothing was coming. And it was actually on the day of one of my very last exams, and I sat down, and it was a sort of song which actually developed out of a guitar part, and then I just started singing, and that was actually how the verses of Love of the Father came out. And so it was sort of just this melody which I had, and slowly from there I started putting lyrics to it and giving it a bit more of a, I guess, a bit more substance beyond the song. And within about 20 minutes, I'd actually written the entire sort of first version of the song.
And this was a long wrestle. Although the initial kernel of the song was written very quickly, the wrestle over the simplest part, just the chorus, what did he say in response to all these amazing things that we've sung about in the verse? Like, what is it that's going to be like, yes, this is what we want to sing now?
It was a process of probably about 12 months of going back and refining sections and refining what the song is actually about. How can we make it better? How can we improve? How can we make sure that every section of the song points to the same idea, the same thing, develops the ideas?
And whenever I think about this song, I think about these chats that James and I would have and these different melodies we would sing and kind of exploring this out. I remember really clearly going to lunch actually after a session and just chatting about it a lot. And in particular, we're talking about what we sing, we are the children of God, we are the people of God, you know, what is it? That chorus there to do with how we are the people of God. With the freedom. And that freedom, and to see kids as young as 5 or 6, being able to unpack that there. Church family, Harrison Paul's singing that, and it's a song that we've probably sung hundreds of times, and yet it's still, it just opens up that joy. You can't help but sing along, to tap along, to clap, to feel energized just from singing it.
And we sort of took that step back and we saw, hey, this is 1 John 3:1 that says, see what great love the Father has lavished on us that we can be called our children of God. And that is where that idea of how great is the love of the Father.
I think my favourite part of this is the bridge, when we just kind of like, you know what, we're stepping back for a bit here, and we're saying, this is the song of the redeemed, right? So we're like kind of looking into the song at this point. We've always been singing the way the children of God, and now we're stepping back and going, yeah, this is the song of the redeemed, the ransomed and the free. Given life at such a price. This is love. This is all. It's like a commentary of all things. I think it's just this kind of special moment. Often, when I hear this song being sung, it's the chorus after the bridge that explodes, and I think it's because, yeah, just kind of like, yes, that's right. This is what we're doing. It's a very special song.
Sing him on the throne, hear the voices.
family Holy God is a special one for us. And it's interesting, it became the name of the whole project as well, the album project for us. In many ways, it's because this song answers a lot of the questions that the rest of the album asks. You know, the rest of the album pointing towards this God that we worship.
I guess this is the vision that Richard Johnny both asked to us in doing this whole album project, in naming your own Holy God, being about the song, is that this whole thing exists because we worship a God who gives us a reason to. And I think the vision that Rich and Johnny set for us is that this album is called Only a Holy God, because that is like our, that is what the vision is to be like. And what we're trying to do is help churches to sing those words, who else would do this, who else would be able to do this for.
This was the first release that we did off the album, and so we pushed it out as a single beforehand, and we got some great feedback from him. And one of the pieces of feedback I treasure very much, it was from a church in a country that I'm not allowed to name. In fact, I didn't even tell them. It gave me a geographical region. I'm not even going to do that, but they're in an area where it's illegal to be a Christian, and they face real threat of persecution. They had to be here all. They said they can sing this song. And I think it's such an amazing opportunity. And it's very common, actually, that God can use this song to bring them to resource them, a church in a place like that. I think about them singing, who else can be stopped? And darkness trembles when we are all God. That added a whole new meaning for me. That they are in a place where it's dangerous to be a Christian, and yet they're under the shield. Who really controls everything, controls nature. He makes the kings bow down before him. That's the truth. He makes the darkness tremble him. And it's really cool to be thinking about something like that situation.
When we started our first conversations about what it might look like, one thing that we really wanted to capture was this isn't a particular worship leader or a particular worship team. This is the church singing praises to God. And so, how better else to do that? But put the band down and into the congregation. Or you just wanted to wrap the band around with so that we can all feel like we're singing together, singing with each other, and particularly this atmosphere of we're doing this together. And it does present some challenges when we're trying to capture things very clearly. But we'll get the right people when we bring as a chief.
Yeah, we had like this crazy time where we were writing, and we did a ton of co-writing in all different combinations. People that you've never really written with before, and just sort of sharing your heart with each other, and I guess sharpening in that sense of learning each other's styles. And I remember we had a ton of different songs. I remember we wrote them all up on the whiteboard and sort of looked at all the songs that God has given us that we can't get together. From there, we sort of, I guess, went through that refining process, and we came out with the songs that we ended up recording.
One of the key aspects of launching songs in our church is we first bring them to a really small setting in our team nights. And so what that looks like is maybe the person who wrote the song and the other people can just without us. Really good feel for, I guess, how they sound when you're singing. Because it can sound great. But we really value that time of launching songs in team nights. And yeah, we did that throughout the process, test run some songs, moving through that whole work. We had some really good worship from those parts. Just getting
we found out it was, I think, maybe 3 or 4 days before we were going to be launching the album at that church, and we got news that there had been, I guess, a bit of a hold-up with the CDs, and so they were stuck overseas. And so we had, we told our church, hey, we have a big album order. You're going to be able to get a copy of the CD, but the one problem was that we didn't have it. the CDs. And so we found out, you know, beforehand that they were probably only going to make it to Melbourne. To Melbourne by the weekend to finally have a movie. And so you know, one of the guys, of the team, absolute hero, put his hand up and said, hey, I'll drive down to Melbourne with another one of these last two maps to have. Maybe half hours. And so a day or so before the album launched, I jumped in the car, drove all the way to Melbourne, picked the CDs up, and came all the way back. And so we had them that Sunday for church, but it was one of those cases where, you know, it didn't work out how we thought it was going to work out, but, you know, God's thought it was otherwise. Yeah. And we still had those CDs for church.
And those two words are all we have to say. Who else? Who else could rescue me from my faith? Who else could do these crazy things that, yeah, are being spoken about in this song, and I've played in this song. Who else could whisper? And darkness itself trembles.
And yeah, this was a song that was handed back to us. And it was because they said, and at first we were like, oh, you know, it hurts a bit. But actually, the more we thought about it, the more we were like, actually, yeah, we're missing out on the opportunity. We thought about it a lot and then rebuilt the fourth verse. And now, like I said, I feel like that is the climax of the song. So we sing about this word. We sing about this word. We sing about his mercy, and then we sing about his tender heart to come and take us. And it's interesting at the end of that, we say, who else would do this? Who else would ask him to call him Father? Only a holy God, to only my God. And it's at this point, usually the song, when we sing the chorus, the room lifts. Yes, come, let's worship you. Let's sing, let's praise our holy God. It's beautiful.
Thank you. My name's Rich. I help with the City Align team here. I do a lot of the songwriting and helping to get the albums as well. I've been doing music for most of my life and I love it. I'm passionate about it. And I'm particularly passionate about seeing churches equipped with songs that are simple, easy to sing, but full of biblical truths. Here at City Light, we're particularly passionate about not just what happens on a Sunday, not just what happens in those 3 minutes when people sing songs, but about what happens the week after as these trees wrap around people's minds. We take it very seriously because what we're doing here is essentially teaching theology. And so we have enormous responsibility and enormous privilege to be able to put theological truths into people's hearts. To make songs that are very accessible for churches. Jerusalem was a song that we wrote a few years ago and it was on our first album, Yours Alone. And the way we wrote Jerusalem in terms of its melody, it went through a few different iterations of melody, but we wanted to write something with essentially something very easy to grab hold of, something quite predictable, actually. We wanted to create that as a vehicle for the song because the story that we're telling here is a very, very powerful story. So we want people to engage with the story more than we want them to engage with the melody. We want the melody to work and we want it to be able to be sung well, but we want people engaging with this story.
You know, I remember the first time that Rich and Johnny showed me this song in this very room, actually, and hearing those words for the first time, I was left really quite unsettled with it, how the story of Jesus coming to the cross and what that meant for me as a follower of him. I think the words of this song so beautifully articulate what that would have been like to be on that journey.
We wrote this song so that people would, we're hoping that they could feel, hear and see the rawness, the ugliness of this story as he walks to that. So that's what this song's about. We wanted to kind of keep it present tense and wanted to you're experiencing it.
I don't know, it's really hard to not picture yourself standing there watching that when you sing these words. The lyric for me that has weighed most heavily on my heart and actually makes me still down at the top of some of this song to this day, the lyric, "Let the soldiers hold and battle him down." Jesus knew exactly what he was getting himself into. He knew that the weight of my sin, as I stood there and cried for murder, he knew he had to let them hold him down on that cross. And in my heart, I have to sing that now. This is my King, this is my Saviour. But in order for him to be that for me, I need to let them hold him down. And that just weighed very heavily on my heart. When you leave